this is the solution of problem set 2, question 12.8. The first question is asking you to show that the PI and UIS is correlated. So the ways to do it is to first need to find express the price as a function of all the other stuff. Especially you need to express this as a function of UIS. Then you can apply the covariance formula and find that they are not equal to zero. As a result, you can show that they are not correlated. Then in the part B, you have to show that beta 1 hat is inconsistent. Inconsistent means that the estimator beta 1 hat does not converge to beta 1 when n becomes large. Therefore, you can apply the beta 1 hat formula, that is covariance derived by the variance. Then you can express Q1S to be beta 0 plus beta 1 PI plus UIS. Eventually, you can find out that the beta 1 hat will converge to beta 1 plus some terms. And in part A, we have shows that the covariance of UIS and PI is not equal to 0. That means the beta I hat does not converge to beta I, or beta 1 hat does not converge to beta 1. As a result, this is the proof of inconsistent. Finally, part C. The question asks you how to estimate beta 1, beta 0, and gamma 0. Beta 0 and gamma 0 are not easy to define because this is just the expected value of y minus beta 1 hat times the expected value of x. But how to find the beta 1 hat, as this is and this suffer from some problem. Okay, so since the covariance of ui and the independent variables are not equal to zero, you need to use an instrument to deal with the problem. So you need to find an instrument z that first the covariance of instrument z and p is not equal to zero. Second, the covariance of instrument and uis is equal to zero. Then if you find this instrument, you can estimate the beta 1 hat by the two-stage least square estimations. And beta 1 hat would be equal to the sample covariance between Z and Q1S derived by sample covariance of Z and PI. So this is the solution of 12.8. And this is the solution of 12.10. And in this question, you are asked whether the beta 1 hat is consistent or not. Again, applying the formula, beta I hat is equal to the covariance of the instrument and y derived by the covariance of instrument and x. Then you can break yi equal to the beta 0 plus beta 1 xi plus beta 2 wi plus ui. Then you can rewrite it as beta 1 plus the beta 2 times covariance of zi wi and derived by variance of zi and xi. Covariance of zi and xi, so there is a typo in the denominator. And here you can see that in question A, if the covariance of Zi and Wi is equal to zero, then you can see the beta 1 hat converge to beta 1. So this is consistent. And in part B, if covariance of Zi and Wi is not equal to zero, then beta 1 hat does not converge to beta 1, and this shows that the case is inconsistent. Although the question does not ask you the follow-up questions, so if beta 2 is equal to 0, then no matter whether the covariance of Zi and Wi is equal to 0 or not, beta 1 hat still converge to beta 1. Therefore, if beta 2 is indeed 0, then again this is beta 1 hat is still consistent.